बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहु। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास, 10th क्लास कंप्यूटर, चैप्टर नंबर 3, इनपुट एंड आउटपुट हैंडलिंग। एंड टुडे वी हैव लेक्चर नंबर 16। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर नंबर 2, and today we start the new chapter number 3, input and output handling. So in this chapter our first topic is input and output functions, and we have some subtopics: 3.1.1 output functions, input functions, statements, terminator, format specifier, escape sequence. Today we discuss about the main topic, input and output functions, and also we discuss about these three topics. Number 1, output functions. Number 2, input functions. And number 3, statement terminator. So let's start from the input and output function. Now, what do you mean by the input and output function? In programming language or in computer, whenever we use the word input, it means we have to feed data into the computer. As we know that most commonly used input devices are keyboard and mouse, and whenever we have to input some data into the computer, mostly we use the keyboards. So same as we know that the keyboard is the most commonly used input device for enter the data into the computer, so when we use the C language, so also we input the data from the keyboard. So in C language, keyboard is also the most commonly used input device. Now, in any programming language, input means to enter or feed data into the computer program. Okay, and output. Output means after the processing of the program, when we process on the problem and find the solution of the problem, then how we will display our output. So output in the functions or output in the C language means that what the computer produces after the processing of the data, or we can say that what thing or which thing can be print on the printer, or we can say that which thing or which result will display after the processing on the monitor. These are the things known as the output. Now the C language provide us many input and output functions which we use in this language, but we discuss here only two functions: one function for the input and one for the output, which are most commonly used in the C language. We don't discuss here any other input output functions because we don't use any other input output function in the C language at your stage. So that's why in chapter number 3 we only discuss about the two main functions. First is the printf and second is the scanf. So let's move to the next slide, output function. Again, what do you mean by the output function? In computer programming, output means to display the information or anything on your printer, LCD or monitor after the processing of the program. When you execute your program, it will produce some output as a result. So we have to display that output as a result on your printer, monitor, or LCD. So we discuss here only one output function. C language provides different functions to produce the output, but we discuss here only one output function, that is the printf function. Because in your syllabus or in this stage, we only use this single output function, that is called the printf function. So we only discuss about this function. Okay, now let's move to the next slide. The printf function. Now, the printf function is used to print text, constant, values of the variable and expression on the screen in the specified format. We know that as we write the algorithm and we write the draw the flow chart of the problem. So flow chart have its own syntax, algorithms have its own syntax. Syntax means the rules according to which we write a statement in our program. Syntax are the rules according to which we write a statement in our program, or we can say that the rules according to which we solve our problem. Okay, so we have to follow the syntax of the C language. So everything have the syntax, as in the flow chart, when we have to draw the flow chart, so we have to draw flow chart with the help of some symbols. As we know that first symbol is this rectangular, and we also use this diamond shape symbols, diamond for the conditions and rectangular for the process. Okay, so it means everything in the C language have its own syntax. So the printf function have its own syntax. What are the syntax for the printf function? For the printf function, the syntax is, first of all, we have to write printf. Then bracket, then control strings, comma, and list of arguments. Bracket close and semicolon. Now, what do you mean by the control string and what are the list of arguments? Okay, now the control string. The control string consists of the text, format specifier, escape sequence, any other variable, constant, anything which are written in the double quotes. Okay, the main thing is which are written in the double quotes. Okay, control string always written in the double quotes, as we know that inverted commas. Okay, so if we write the anything in the printf and we write in the inverted commas, so that statement called the control string. Control string. Okay, now what is a format specifier? Escape sequence. So format specifier specifies the format according to which a value is to be printed. Format specifier specifies the format according to which a value is to be printed. Let's suppose if we have a program and we have to print the value 10. So format specify tell us we have to print the integer value, means 10. And format specifier also tell you, you have to print now floating point values, means 15.5. And format specifier also tells you, now you have to print character. Okay, so for format specifier is used to specify the format according to which the value is to be printed on your screen. Now, what do you mean by the escape sequence? Second word which we use in the control string. So escape sequence controls the printing on the output devices. Escape sequence control the printing on the output devices. Now, the word control. Control the printing. Now, what do you mean by the control the printing? Control the printing means escape sequence. When we use the escape sequence in our program, how it controls the printing? Control the printing means, let's suppose we have to display the 5 lines. So we can use the escape sequence as, now let's suppose we write Muhammad Ali, okay, and also we write here Muhammad Ahmed, okay, and also we write here Muhammad Adil. So all these names are written in single line. Muhammad, let's call Asif. Okay, now when we use the escape sequence, okay, when we use this escape sequence, so we can write this single line into multiple lines. How? Let's suppose when we use the escape sequence, so we can write here Muhammad Ali, next is Muhammad Ahmed, Muhammad Adil, Muhammad Asif. Okay, so how we write this? With the help of the escape sequence. Okay, so if we don't use the escape sequence, so if we write Muhammad Ali, Muhammad Ahmed, Muhammad Adil, Muhammad Asif in the inverted commas, it will display as the Muhammad Ali, Muhammad Ahmed, Muhammad Adil, Muhammad Asif. But when we use the escape sequence, it controls the printing. Control means it's up to you how to print the Muhammad Ali, Muhammad Ahmed, Muhammad Adil and Muhammad Asif. So you can print the Muhammad Ali, Muhammad Ahmed in next line, Muhammad Adil in the next line and Muhammad Asif on the next line. And you can also print the Muhammad Ali and some space after the 8 spaces you can write the Muhammad Ahmed. After the 8 spaces, you can write the Muhammad Adil, and after the 8 spaces, you can write the Muhammad Asif. So that is the purpose of the escape sequence. Okay, I hope now you understand what is the purpose of escape sequence. And in our next lecture, we will discuss in detail what are the escape sequence and how it works in the program. So today you have to understand only the definition of escape sequence. Escape sequence controls the printing on the output device. And I gave you this one example. That is, now move to the next slide. The second word which we learn in this printf function, first is control string. Second is list of arguments. Now, what do you mean by the list of arguments? The list of argument consists of a list of variables, constants, and arithmetic operations separated by the commas, whose values are to be printed. Means, if we have to print some values on our screen, and let's suppose we have the two variables A and B. A have the value 5, B have the 10. So sum is A plus B is 15. So if we want to display the sum, so we write the sum in the list of arguments. And when we write the sum in the list of argument, it will display the answer of the sum, which we store in the variable sum. So list of arguments contains the variable, constants, and arithmetic operations. And if we have the more than one variables, so we can separate the variables with the help of comma. and we only write the variables in the list of arguments whose values we want to display on the monitor. Okay, now how the values will display on the monitor? The values on the monitor will display according to the corresponding format specifier. Let's take an example. Okay, let's suppose printf, and here we have the inverted commas and format specify %d and %d. Now comma, okay, now a comma b. So when we write the printf statement like this, so %d means this %d execute the value of a, and next %d execute the value of b. So it means when we write the printf statement in our program, so it will execute, or we can say that it will print the values according to the corresponding format specifier. Means a will print the value according to the %d, and b will print the value according to the %d. Okay, now if we have this simple message, let's suppose if we write the message I love Pakistan. Okay, I love Pakistan. Printf, I love Pakistan. So now in this printf function, we don't need to write any list of arguments, because in this statement we don't use any values from the variable. Okay, we simply write the I love Pakistan. Simple. So we don't use any values of the variable, so that's why we don't write any list of arguments. So that's why we don't write here comma and any variable. Okay, now following is an example of the printf function. Printf backslash n, the value of a is %d and the value of b is %d, full stop, double comma. Now comma a comma b. Let's suppose the value of a is 3 and the value of b is 4. Let's suppose, okay. So this line will be displayed on your monitor like the value of a is 3 and the value of b is 4. And this for escape sequence backslash n, this escape sequence is used when we have to print the statement on your next line. So now we use backslash n, so that's why we have to print this line on the next line. And this a have the value 3. So here we use the %d. %d refers to the a. %d refers to a. It means this %d refers to this a. This a, okay. And this next %d refers to this b. It means the value of a is %d. Then we write %d, and where we write the %d? So we replace the %d with the value of a, and a has the 3. So, and the value of b is, again we have %d. So %d replace the value of b. B has the 4. So that's why we print the value of a is 3 and the value of b is 4. Okay. Now input function. What do you mean by the input function? In computer programming, input means to feed the data into the computer through an input device. Now, C language also provides the different input functions, but we only discuss here scanf, this function. Now, next is how we use the scanf function. The scanf function is used to get the values from the into the variable from the keyboard during the execution of the program. Now, what is the syntax for getting the values? Again, the syntax of scanf is we write scanf, again inverted commas, format specifier, comma, list of variables. Now, format specifier, which we already discussed in our previous slides. Again, I will tell you the format specifier. The format specifier specifies the format of the variable. Means, format specifier tell us what type of data will you get from the user. Means, can you get the 15 or can you get the 15.5 or can you get the Muhammad Ali, Muhammad Adil, Muhammad Ahmed? So, format specifier tells you what type of data you will get from the user. Okay, now the format specifier are written within the double quotes again or without spaces, and we can use the spaces. Now, the second word, list of variables. What do you mean by the list of variables in the scanf? Now, the list of variables consists the list of the variables separated by the comma into which the variables to be entered. Means, if we have to enter the value of A, let's suppose in a program, programmer will ask the user, enter your age. Or we can say that the program will ask you to enter the price of milk, enter the price of sugar, enter the price of, let's suppose, rice. So now, user gives you the price of sugar, milk, rice. So how many variables? 3 variables. So the list of variables contains the 3 variable, milk, sugar, and rice. And these variables are separated with the help of commas. First of all, we write the milk, okay? Let's suppose for milk, we say that we use variable M. And for the sugar, we use S. And for the rice, we use R. But the difference between the list of variables and list of arguments is, in printf, we only write comma, okay? But here we also write the one extra sign, this sign, with all the variables, okay? So when we write this symbol with all the variables, so it will becomes the list of variables which we use for the getting values from the variable, okay? Now, let's move to the next slide. Now, let's take an example. The example is scanf %d %d. Now, it means it will take the value in variable A, and %d indicates that it will take the integer value. %d is used for the integer. Integer means in variable A, we will get the, let's suppose, value 5, 10, 15, 20, any integer. And in %d, we will get the, again, the integer value. Means, let's suppose, we will take the 50, 200, 100, 150, any value. Okay, so %d specifies that. Now, let's take an example. Now, that is the program, void main void, int abc, printf, enter the first number, scanf. Now, here is the int abc. It means it indicates that int means integer. Now ABC will take the values integer, means it does not take the any value which contains the point. So A will take the, let's suppose 5, 10, 15, any number, B and C also. Next statement, printf. When the controller comes to the second statement, printf, it will display the message on your print monitor or LCD. How it will display? Enter the first number, because that is written in the inverted commas. And we know that the message which is written in the inverted commas will display as it is on your monitor. So it will display enter the first number, semicolon. Now next is scanf, percent D A. Percent D is used for the integer. So it will take the input integer number and take in the variable A, which we use after the comma. After the comma, we have the variable A. So when a user enter the 15, it will store into variable A. Now, let's suppose when you enter 15, again, you will get a new statement, enter the second number. So you will, let's suppose, enter the 5. So 5 will store in B, because we write here variable B. Now, when A get 15, B get 5, on the next line, we have the C equal to A plus B means 20. When controller comes to the second last line, printf, now it will display on your screen the sum is, and percent D replaced with C. We know that percent D display the value of C, and C have the 15 here. So the sum is 20, which is your required answer. Okay. These are all the theory I explained in previous slide. Now, the last topic, 3.1.3, statement terminator. Now, what do you mean by the statement terminator? Statement terminator is called the semicolon. This symbol is necessary for each statement in the C language. We have to write the semicolon at the end of every statement in the C language. If we don't write the semicolon at the end of the C language statement, so C compiler will give you an error message during the compilation, and the program will not be compiled. It displays the message on your screen. So it means this small symbol semicolon have the great importance in your C language program. So each and every statement must have the semicolon at the end of that statement. Here, int ABC, we have semicolon. Again, printf at the end, we have semicolon. Semicolon, semicolon. But, when we write the condition, so we don't write the semicolon. Only when we write the condition, we don't write the semicolon. Otherwise, in all these step of instructions in C language, you have to write the semicolon at the end of the statement. If you don't write semicolon, it will display the error message on your screen. Now, if you have any problem, any question, any doubt related to today's topic only, you can text me. I'm here to solve your problems. So hurry up.